everyone, this is Sharon from Sharon at Sea Travel. As a travel agent, one of the most frequently asked questions I've received over the last couple of months with all the cruise cancellations out there is, should I book a cruise or should I rebook my canceled cruise in 2020? Well, I have a few answers for you and I'm going to go over five areas to consider right after this. Travel is a very personal decision and it's not something that a travel agent or anyone can make for you for that matter. So I try to give my clients some of the best information I know out there to just help them make the best decision for themselves. But before we get started, if you like cruise and travel content and you are not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so you'll get notified when we post new content or when we go live. We go live every Monday evening and we talk all about cruising, traveling, and so much more. So come join the fun. So now let's dive right into the benefits and protections that the different cruise lines are offering if you book or rebook a cruise in 2020. I'm going to talk about five reasons it's a good idea to book or rebook a cruise in 2020. Number one, perks for 2020. So many cruise lines right now are offering added benefits and perks to rebooking a cruise in 2020 or booking a cruise in 2020. And you don't necessarily have to sail in 2020. You can sometimes sail out in 2021, 2022, and these are still applying. So some are offering onboard credit, some are offering future cruise credits, free gratuities, drink packages. Depending on the cruise line, they are all offering their own set of perks out there basically. So check out your favorite cruise line, see what they're offering. If you're working with a travel agent, they get notified on a regular basis of all the additional perks that are going on for that time frame. If not, check out the website, monitor it yourself, and see what perks are out there for you. Number two, limited capacity sailing. As the cruise lines get back out there sailing, all indications are that they are going to be sailing at limited capacity. So if you're during some of the reopening phases, some of the first people back out there sailing, you are gonna benefit from less crowded ships. Now, that's a nice option. So take advantage of the less crowded ships and enjoy your vacation. And this should make a lot of people feel a little more confident while sailing safely during these times. Number three, unique itineraries. So as the cruise lines start sailing again, a lot of the ports may not be open yet. So some of the itineraries may be changing. Some cruise lines are kind of setting up some unique itineraries, maybe going to some places that they don't normally go to. They are also bringing in a lot of shorter sailings, and you may be visiting some of their private islands a little more than in the past as well. So keep that in mind. Always go into a cruise, especially now, with an open mind that your itinerary may change. Number four, confidence and peace of mind. So some of the cruise lines are offering programs such as Cruise with Confidence and Peace of Mind. This is where they are protecting some of the monies you've invested into your cruise, your deposits through 2020, and some even through 2021 and 2022. So this can help you feel a little bit confident that your money's safe and protected and that you're not gonna lose it if you rebook your cruise. And number five, an upgraded experience. So for some of you that have a future cruise credit already, some cruise lines are adding a little additional monetary value. So if you're rebooking your cruise in the near future, you may reap a few extra rewards with that. For example, some cruise lines are adding additional onboard credit to their bookings. So this is a great time to take advantage of that. And there's a little word out there that some cruise lines may be offering some upgrades as it gets closer to their sailing dates. With the ships being less full, not sailing at full capacity, they may upgrade people for no additional charge to balcony rooms from interiors and things like that. So kind of watch your booking as it gets closer and maybe even call the cruise line as it gets closer a few weeks out and inquire about this as well. Because sometimes they don't always tell you things, but when you inquire, you know, you find out that, hey, maybe I can get a free upgrade. So it's always worth checking out, right? Even though the COVID-19 has kind of thrown all of us off on our day-to-day routines and we feel like travel and cruising is just not in our future. Well, let's keep a positive attitude out there and be very hopeful that cruising will be back in 2020, and it is going to be as good as it ever was, especially after not cruising for a while. I think many people are going to be very excited to just be back out on the water sailing. Hope this was helpful, and if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and feel free to share it with your family and friends. Thanks for watching, and until next time, happy cruising and safe travels.